The sun was up now, and Palpatine had lost track of how long he had been standing on the outskirts of town. He looked back down at his robes and tried to rub the blood off his cloak. He just ended up staining his hands. He knew that whatever happened back at the shop was the will of the dark side of the Force flowing through him. Suddenly, someone emerged from the hut that the boy went into. It was the boy and what appeared to be his mother. There was something oddly familiar about that woman. He was sure that he had seen her before, but he couldn't quite pinpoint where. They were heading back into town, so Palpatine decided to follow them. They came up to Watto's junk shop to see a crowd standing around outside. The two entered the shop to see what was going on. Palpatine knew that he had to get in there as well, so he grabbed some new robes from a nearby vendor, quickly changed, and went inside the shop. He entered the shop to find it in disarray, but Watto was nowhere to be found. Suddenly, it all came back to him about what happened when he was there last night. The memories came flooding back like visions of someone that was using his body, and he was left there watching what was happening. The boy had just left to go home for the day. Now Palpatine's chance to confront the Toradarian about the boy had finally arrived. He found the shop owner in the back, closing down for the day.
"You're here about the boy," said Watto.
This surprised Palpatine. How did this Toradarian know what Palpatine was there for if he didn't even know the boy or who this Toradarian was prior to today?
"Your master told me that you would be here for the boy eventually,"
remarked Watto as if he could read Palpatine's thoughts. This angered Palpatine, for he was sure that his master wasn't as smart as this. After all, he did fall at his hands and was no more because of him and his plan. Palpatine couldn't take it anymore. The thought that his master had somehow planned all this drove him into a rage. He would get this boy to join him. First, he had to get rid of the Toradarian. He knew that they couldn't be persuaded, so force was his only option. He started to shock Watto with the strongest force lightning that he could muster. The lightning was a vibrant violet in color, and it burnt hair and melted skin on contact. Palpatine could smell the burnt skin and hair rising from the Toradarian. Even with his lightning hitting him and burning Watto, he remained unshaken by the torture. Palpatine decided to switch tactics and crush Watto with the Force. He started to use the Force to constrict Watto like a can. Watto began to scream as he got smaller. It wouldn't be long now till he was out of the way and he could take the boy. It had been nearly a minute of this constricting Force when Watto imploded from the pressure and his blood sprayed Palpatine's robes. Now that Watto was gone, Palpatine had to dispose of the body. It wasn't much bigger than a small ball that could fit in your hand. Palpatine grabbed Watto and headed for the outskirts of town to dispose of him and his body. He stopped at the edge of town, got rid of Watto, and found himself staring at a hut that he had never seen before. All of these memories came back to him standing in the shop that was a mess from what happened the night before. Now he had to find the boy and his mother. He had to make sure that his plan could actually continue in its progress. He found the boy and his mom outside the shop, staring off into the distance in shock at what they had just seen inside. Sheev mentioned for them to follow him. He knew that they had no other option, seeing that they would be on the hook for their master's death. He talked to them about their options and what they could do from here. Shmi said that Anakin and her would go with him. Suddenly, Sheev remembered this woman. The mere mention of the boy's name uttered by his mother brought some more memories back into focus. Sheev remembered the first time coming to this planet. He remembered his master meeting with Shmi, and then he remembered his master blocking his memories, and he couldn't remember much more than that. Once again, he couldn't believe that his master had actually planned out this far after his death, or maybe his master didn't even plan for his death. That didn't matter anymore. His master was dead. Only Palpatine's plan was in action now. Still, he couldn't help feeling like his master was using him, that somehow his master had actually planned for all this to happen. This didn't matter anymore. This was something that he could worry about another day. For now, they had to get off Tatooine and get back to Coruscant. If you like this What If, please sure to check out this playlist over here. Click on that, enjoy those other What Ifs, and I'll see you guys in the next one. May the Force be with you.